As a beginner in the PLC programming, it is really important to understand the sequence of operation of the PLCs. For example, if an output is to be turned on or an input needed to be updated in the program, it seems that processor do it instantly. However, the processor requires some time to make these changes. The outputs and the inputs can only be updated once the PLC scan gets to an appropriate step in the PLC scan sequence. The PLC scan sequence consists of three steps. Number one, scan input image data table. Number two, execute program. Number three, update output image table. The time required by the CPU to go through these steps is called as PLC scan time. In step number one, the PLC processor go and scan the input image table. If any input turns on, PLC processor will update the input in the PLC input image table. Now, as the PLC has information which PLC inputs are on or off, the PLC processor goes to the step number two. Here it will execute the PLC program sequence. The PLC processor will update the status of the inputs in the ladder logic and generate results to determine which outputs need to be turned on or off. Once the PLC have this information about the outputs, it will go to the step number three. Here, the PLC will update the output image table. To turn on an output, it will put 1, and to turn off the output, it will put 0 in the image table. And outputs get turned on or off according to the result PLC determined in the step number 2. From step 3, the PLC scan cycle will go back to the step 1 to scan the input image table, and this cycle goes on indefinitely until the PLC is powered on. Time taken by the PLC to scan the inputs, solve the logic, and update the outputs is called PLC scan time. The PLC scan time varies from 0 millisecond to 150 millisecond, and it can be as large as 1000 milliseconds. The variation in the scan time depends on the following factors: number of inputs, length of the logic, and number of outputs. PLC scan time can be a big issue with the high-speed applications. Let's say you are controlling a high-speed sorting facility. Your encoders are supplying 1000 pulses per revolution for every foot of the conveyor, and the conveyor speed can be up to 140 feet per minute. This is over 2000 pulse signal per second, or over 2 pulses every millisecond, and at that rate, the average CPU is bound to miss few pulses, and in turn could cause a diverter arm to miss or crush a box. In these situations, specially designed modules like high-speed counters can be used to ensure no pulses are missed. These counters are designed to work independently from the CPU scan, meaning they have their own processor dedicated to tracking the number of pulses coming in. These high-speed cards then feed the count over to the CPU when it is required. In this way, we can improve the PLC scan time. This is all about the PLC scan cycle. Do consider subscribing. Until next video, take care and goodbye.